All right, so you're there. You're at that very moment where you've got money in hand, money that is burning a hole in your pocket. You're ready to invest. Maybe you set a goal to be out of debt and you're debt free now and you're ready to throw as much money as possible into the stock market. You're so excited, you're just running around in circles, you're ready to start investing. But you have no idea where to put your money. If you're a brand new investor, and even if you're a seasoned investor, this video might be the exact thing you need to watch. In this video, I'm gonna share with you three specific questions you must ask yourself before you invest a single cent into the stock market. The questions you ask yourself, and more importantly, the answers you give after thinking about them, will dictate not only how much you invest, but where you invest, and what type of account you invest in. Every single investor is different. Their circumstances, their life experiences, what they want to accomplish with their money, everybody's set of circumstances is different. And it's critical you know the answer to these three questions. So don't invest yet. Make sure you give me the next 5 to 10 minutes of your time. Let's cover the three big questions you need to answer as a beginning investor. Let's get started. Hey guys, before we get started, make sure to hit that subscribe button below the video to ensure you do not miss any future videos I post. Make sure to leave a comment below saying you subscribed, and I promise to respond personally to your comment. All right guys, you know I never want to waste your time, so let's go ahead and jump right into the content here. There are three huge questions, monumental for your investing journey, that you need to ask yourself and answer before you start investing, because it's going to put yourself in a position to invest the smart and strategic way given what you want to accomplish. And let's jump right into it right here. The very first question you should ask yourself is, what are your goals? Now, I admit, that's a pretty broad question, so let's see if we can narrow the scope here a little bit. What do you want to accomplish with the money you are investing? That might seem like a very simple and straightforward question, but the truth of the matter is, everybody's answer is a little bit different. Are you trying to invest for retirement? If yes, how much money do you want to have and when? Are you trying to tap out right at age 59 and a half when you can access your IRA account? Or maybe you love your job and you can't even imagine not working where you do right now, even past the age of 70. Do you want to join the FIRE movement? Do you want to be financially independent and retire early? Do you love the idea of living off your investments and traveling the world, or at least being just off the grid and not be required to show up 9 to 5 at your job every day? Perhaps you're not trying to save for retirement or trying to retire early. You're just trying to build an investment portfolio that can be a legacy portfolio, one that you can pass on to your kids and your kids' kids. And think of just the impact you could have on the world with this type of portfolio. Maybe that's your goal. Maybe you're trying to cash flow a trip around the country in an RV for an entire year with your 4 kids and your wife. Everybody's goals and objectives are just a little bit different. And knowing exactly what you want to accomplish with your money is going to dictate not only how much you're investing, but also what types of investments you want to purchase, and furthermore, the type of investing account you utilize. Let's say you were trying to save a pile of money that was going to either be sold to pay for a trip or be used to cash flow a trip around the country like I'm doing with my 4 kids and my wife and an RV for an entire year traveling the United States. There are a number of different investments you could utilize to make that happen, but one of the first considerations I would need to have is, and what type of account am I going to use to invest? If I invest all this money in an IRA or any type of retirement account, then there are significant tax consequences and penalties if I pull that money out before age 59 and a half. Additionally, if I'm trying to use that money to cash flow the trip and I don't want to sell my investments, I'd rather just continue to build a portfolio that pays me monthly income, then that might dictate the types of investments that I utilize. I know that I'm not going to use a retirement account, I'm going to use a general taxable account for that unique situation, but I also might choose to utilize dividend stocks or maybe other types of investments that focus on cash flow as opposed to capital appreciation. Maybe your situation is you just became debt free and you're trying to invest for retirement. Maybe you feel like you're behind the eight ball a little bit here. You're trying to invest for your retirement so that you can retire at age 59 and a half, right when you can access those funds. In that situation, you know you'd like to use a retirement account because there are definite tax benefits that you can achieve by doing so. But you also then need to hone your strategy on, well, how much money do I need? And I guarantee that's different for every single investor out there. Maybe you want to live off of $4,000 to $5,000 a month, and other people want to have $10,000 a month to utilize for their cash flow expenses. Every situation is different, and that's why it's important to think of these types of questions in advance. Okay, second question you need to ask yourself is, when do I need the money? That's an important consideration. If you need the money in 6 months or 18 months for an important priority such as buying a home, What are you doing investing that money? Do you need the money in 2 years or 20 years? Do you need the money in 18 months to buy a house, or is this money for your retirement? This is an important consideration to think about because your answer when you need the money is going to strongly dictate the types of investments you're comfortable investing in. And it's also going to correlate with the risk tolerance you have. How comfortable do you feel with the proposition of losing money if you need it in 6 months versus needing the money in 20 years? See, the truth of the matter is, data shows, history shows, that the stock market over the long term, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, the stock market undoubtedly, unequivocally goes up. That being said, over the short term, over the next 6 months, over the next 2 weeks, over the next, 18 months, I have no idea what's gonna happen. Could be a complete crapshoot. It could be up one day and down the next. Up one day and then down for the next 3 days. Short-term volatility in the stock markets is to be expected. If this money is something you must have in 6 months, please, I'm not gonna make a formal recommendation here, but if it were me, there's no way I'm investing that money if I need it for a specific goal and objective. If I'm just using this money to speculate, I'm just trying to fly into high-flying stock like Tesla or Neo or something similar, or wanna throw all my money into ARK Invest because, well, I just don't need this money, it's pure speculation, well then that's okay. But if you need this money to pay for your family expenses or you need to buy a house, or something similar to that where it's an important objective, how can we justify investing in the stock market for a short amount of time? Take the lost decade from 1999 to 2009, where the total stock market appreciation was nothing. Unless you owned dividend stocks, individual dividend stocks that were reinvesting dividends and didn't cut their dividend, you saw no type of appreciation in your account. You had $10,000 in 1999, you had $10,000 in 2009. And in between that time frame, you might have been down by as much as 50%. Make sure you know when you need the money before you start investing, because it will dictate how you invest your money. All right, third and final question you must ask yourself and answer before you start investing in the stock market is, what is your risk tolerance? And that actually might be a harder question to answer honestly with yourself. You know, I find it very interesting. I've told my wife this because it's very fascinating. You know, risk tolerance, you would think would be an overarching, comprehensive look into your life with respect to risk, but it's not. When it comes to investing, I am very liberal with my views. I will go ahead and invest a lot of my money. I'd be willing to invest my emergency fund, or at least a portion of it, but if you ask me to park in a parking spot that is going to expire in 15 minutes, but we're not coming back to the car for 45, I will literally lose my mind. I cannot take that kind of risk, which is kind of crazy when you think about the monetary differences between those things. But I recognize the fact that I see risk differently in different aspects of my life. So you need to ask this question honestly to yourself. How comfortable are you with market volatility, or how the stock market goes up and down on a daily or weekly or monthly basis? If you were to know that your account went down by 50% overnight, how would you feel about that? Are you okay with that? Would you see that as an opportunity to buy more shares at lower prices? Or would you lose your freaking mind and want to sell right away? Would you be able to, continue on with life knowing that your investments were down 50%? Or would that be completely consuming for you? And all of these questions come together in the end here, knowing what your goals and objectives are, when you need the money, and how comfortable you are with risk in your portfolio. If you've got a 30-year time horizon, right, and you don't need that money for 30 years, it's to secure your retirement, and you are okay knowing that 30-year time frame that the market will go up and down over time, but over that time frame it will go up, well then what's the big deal if you've got market volatility? At least during the next 15 to 20 years, as we get closer to retirement, we might want to adjust our assets based on when we need the money, but as long as our time frame is 20 or 30 years, what's the big deal? However, if you need this money in 1 year for a down payment on a house, and you are very uncomfortable with market volatility, then why on earth are you not investing in a savings account or maybe a short-term CD, a short-term municipal bond, or something similar to that, where the return is guaranteed, your principal is completely safe? All of these questions bleed together with every investment decision you make. The three questions are gonna be different answers for your retirement account versus maybe your emergency fund, versus your short-term fund to have a house down payment, versus an account you need in 3 to 4 years to take a trip around the country in an RV with your family. Every decision is different, every investor is different, but everybody has to ask these questions if they want to be successful with their investments. Hopefully you found some value from this video, guys. This is a great launching point into making investment decisions, what types of accounts you're gonna utilize. I've got a lot of other videos on my channel related to investing, so make sure to leave your 2 cents in the comments below. Make sure if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any future videos from me. And that's all I got for you guys. Have a great rest of your day, and please continue to stay healthy, both physically and financially. Have a good one.